Hi y'all, welcome back to the Restart Channel, the place where education meets cannabis. My name is Shada, and in today's video, we're diving into the world of cannabinoids to answer a burning question. How do you calculate the amount of THC you're getting from THCA in your cannabis products? Whether you're a consumer, a patient, or just kind of curious, understanding this calculation can really change the way you look at cannabis potency. So let's get into it. First off, let's break down what THCA and THC actually are. THCA, or tetrahydrocannabinolic acid, is a non-psychoactive precursor to THC, which is the compound that gets you high. When cannabis is heated through smoking, vaping, cooking, THCA undergoes a process called decarboxylation, which converts the THCA into THC. Now, the million-dollar question is how much THC comes from THCA? And the magic lies in a simple formula that accounts for the conversion rate from THCA to THC. And it goes a little something like this. To calculate the potential THC, you take the amount of THCA and multiply it by 0.877. Why 0.877, you ask? This number represents the molecular weight difference between THC and THCA, since about 12.3% of THC's weight is lost as carbon dioxide during decarboxylation, you're left with 87.7% of the original weight, which is THC. So let's do a quick example. Say you have cannabis flower that's been lab tested and shows a 20% THCA. Using our formula, you'd calculate the potential THC like this. 20% THCA times 0.877 equals 17.54% THC. This means after decarboxylation, your flower could have up to 17.54% active THC. So understanding this calculation is super important for anyone looking to gauge the potency and effects of their cannabis products accurately. And it's especially crucial for anyone who relies on precise dosing for therapeutic benefits. So to wrap up, remember the key points. THCA converts to THC through heat, AKA decarboxylation, and the conversion formula is THCA multiplied by 0.877, and this helps you estimate the potential THC content in your cannabis. So that's it for today's episode. I hope you found this explanation helpful. If you did, give us a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe for more educational cannabis content. But if you have questions that you're dying for us to answer and cover on our video channel, please drop them in the comments below. And until next time, stay curious and stay high.